sorry.
Hey, I was just heading over to Commander Chase's office. She and Kai are on the way there now.
She's okay.
Yeah, but now Tenet is trapped in there with that army ranger. Chase thinks he's being set up.
Wait, that might fit with why I'm here. I found some of Agent Foster's notes that weren't with the official case file. She was working on a wiretap for a guy named George Bedalian.
Who's George Bedalian?
I was hoping you knew. His name isn't anywhere in the case file.
Her notes say why he was important?
She believed he's the supplier of the black market opioids they've been looking for. But you think the task force didn't give us everything?
Or someone scrubbed Bedalian's name from all the reports. I'll see Chase later. We have to find out what we can about George Bedalian and get it to Tenet.
Hey, so what do we know about this opioid supplier that Foster suspected?
His name's George Bedalian. He runs an import-export business that deals mostly in foods.
But we dug into his financials and they don't add up.
If Foster was right about him smuggling in the opioids, he's been getting away with it for years.
Because he's had help on the inside. Whoever it was that scrubbed Bedalian's name from the case file.
Has to be someone on the task force then, right?
Right. And that's why Agent Foster was keeping her suspicions to herself. She thought one of her colleagues was involved.
The wiretap.
Agent Foster wrote an affidavit for a wiretap on Bedalian before she was killed, and her information was enough for me to get one proved.
The call's coming from a burner.
It's about time. You gonna be able to take care of this?
Yeah, but it's risky. I'll expect a big bonus in addition to my usual payment.
You'll get it.
Oh, she didn't identify herself.
She didn't need to.